Hey, it's your girl Nikki Phillip, and we're with the Plug International. We're here with Loaf Muzik.
Yeah.
Peace.
What up, y'all?
All right, we got here Sean, Zaz.
What's up?
All right. Shadow.
Yeah.
And Oso.
How y'all doing?
Peace.
And we got some questions for y'all. So, first question: how did you guys get into hip hop?
Alright, so boom. How did I get into hip hop? There was an after school program at the school I was going to at this middle school, there was no dance program anymore.
I was breakdancing
at the time, and they had a music program. I passed by like one of the studios one day, and Mr. Singh, he was the one in charge of it. He was like, "Yo, you know, you can do this." Walked in the studio, he had a beat. He was like, "Yo, write something to this and record it." And that's how that happened. Ever since then, I just kept going after school. And that's how I got into like writing lyrics, you know what I mean? After that, that shadow, and it just turned to a whole different thing. Keep it short, yeah.
When I was in Queens, even when I was going to public school, it was just 106 and Park, BET. There was Mario, Ciara was out, like, hip hop, Chiggy, like hip hop was always just a part of the culture that I was in, because you know I'm black. So maybe around ninth grade, I was in my brother's car, and it was like the first day of school, and he played the Jay-Z and Big L freestyle, and that was the first time I heard anything that was that old. And then I started, you know, going back and then finding a love for like the history of hip hop. You know what I'm saying? And that summer, that's when I recorded my first track. And then that's just how, you know, I started making music, right?
Yeah. I think I was like 10, and I lived in Brownsville at the time. My grandmother was from Livonia, and there was a couple of us, my sisters and stuff. And just being bored in the crib, not being able to go outside, because it was mad crazy. Little kids were mad bad back then. Just being bored in the crib, creativity, started imagining shit. And I started writing little raps and stuff. And, just turned into something one day. But yeah, in the crib, probably.
Yeah, imagination. I was 10, I remember being 10 also. I was in my living room, and I saw Kanye's video for Jesus Walks come on the TV. And like, I just sat down and watched the whole shit, and I was like, oh shit, this shit is just fire, the production. I don't know, something, you know, drew me in, and that shit just, after that, I decided I just wanted to try to write, you know? And it was the same year that my older brother had passed, so it was like a way for me to vent and let, you know, whatever I had in my head out. So that was really the start of it for me. And then I just started listening to a lot of other artists, like Akon, that was a big, you know, artist I was listening to. And just then these dudes actually put me on to like older shit that I hadn't even heard before. Like they was putting me on to like Mos Def and Nas and all these dudes that I never heard, I'm like, yo, this is dope. And so it drew me in even more, you know?
So what made you guys form a crew?
So after we all developed like our paths and found hip hop, when we got of age and stuff, it's like, I'd say after grade school. Matter of fact, it's like junior high school. Not even high school. Once everybody got to high school and we started all creating our art, started using social media to stay keep in contact with each other and link up, record songs and shoot videos and stuff. It was just our love for it, and we grew up with each other, so it was like we were brothers at the end of the day too. Well, that was the first thing, was that we knew each other before music, right? Like, they knew each other, me and him knew each other way before any type of rhymes was written. So just the fact that we still was rapping, that was one thing, another thing to have in common. So that's what really made us form a crew. Like,
so how did you guys come up with the name?
It has a meaning, like, you know.
Yeah, absolutely. To build on what you were saying, we was doing like a lot of shows together, open mics all over Manhattan, a couple of Brooklyn. We were just all over the place, just doing live shows before we even had a name, really. Like,
yeah.
We were just writing lyrics and performing. And after a while, we was just like, yo, like, we're doing something. And it became what it is, Loaf Music. Loaf, one sound, one vibration, music, vibration, one sound, Loaf Music. So it was always this idea of everyone bringing their individuality to the table and forming this like, for like when we're Loaf.
It's like the different slices of the Loaf.
Name three hip hop songs that blew your mind.
I got one. Oh, three. Oh, we doing
three.
Three.
Three hip hop joints that blew my mind. Juvenile. Slow Motion. R. Kelly. Believe I Can Fly.
Is this hip hop or R&B?
Just inspiration, period.
Inspiration.
That's what you got.
Back by the
word. Joke.
Word. Like, just the time. Like, me grinding. Because everybody was on their table.
Pete Pablo.
Yeah.
David Banner.
Where is David Banner?
Lupe Fiasco. Hip Hop Saved My Life.
Grinding was lit. Hey Hop from Outkast.
Saved My Life.
Hey Mom.
I would say that shit was crazy. That's another beat that everybody was just doing.
I would say Infinite by Eminem. That shit fucked my head up when I first heard that shit.
On Your Head. Showing
people. That's Travis Slide. You know, Travis Slide to Brooklyn, my most. How that beat switches.
That was. Speaking of most, Mathematics?
Mathematics, yo, I remember.
I noticed you said 300 and said like 300, so we don't move on to that. What inspires you to ride around with me
everyday life.
That's what inspires me to write in my everyday life. That would just have to be the word that's like in my mind is investment. And it's like, it's faith. Cause I started this when I was young, you have a certain potential. And then when you get older, you in the real world and you have real things to think about. And some people stray away from their dreams. So it's like for me to write every day is just a penance to my soul and the person that I want to be, you know? Straight up, yeah.
I definitely have to agree with that. I'd be feeling the same way, like what inspires me to write and keep on doing it. I'd be asking myself that shit every day, bringing me back to the reason why I even write. And that's not, I said it earlier when we was in the studio, it's not really to plant the seed and want the tree to grow and then for the fruit. I don't want the fruit. It's really the whole purpose of planting the seed. Go back to verses, writing verses. First verses I ever came across was in the Bible. So that shows me that the verses that they was writing in the scriptures was powerful words that were meant to, for whoever to read it, no matter if the person who wrote it is dead or not. It was a message, so that's what really keeps me going and keeps me writing. It's like, I gotta keep on journalizing the message. There has to be a reason. Someone, when they read this or when they hear it, they get the inspiration from it, and then they plant their seeds and they keep going. So it's really the inspiration to keep the cycle going.
It's really like, for me, I agree with exactly what they said. It's also like, I see it as you get to paint your experiences. You know what I mean? You get to paint what you see, how you see things. You know what I'm saying? It's like, when you're able to paint your experiences and what you've been through and what you've seen and what you've experienced, everything, you're understanding that there's going to be souls that hear this and they're going to be able to resonate with everything that you just said. You know, it's like, everybody has a story, but that doesn't mean that our stories don't correlate. You know what I'm saying? So when somebody hears something that really hits their soul, it's a different type of feeling, you know? And knowing that something that I went through, I could write it down and somebody else to hear it and be like, oh shit, I know exactly what that's like. That keeps me going to like want to be a voice for people, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. They summed it up pretty much. A sense of responsibility, understanding that your voice is unique, and there are other like-minded individuals who relate to your voice and your story, so that keeps the, you know, it gives you a sense of a need, a drive to like, you know, keep speaking to those, reaching out to those. I think that's what makes hip-hop dope. Like, and if you single it out in that way, like you was, you know, referred it to like verses, and also it can be referred to like speeches.
Tell
like
me, right?
Messages,
it's verses.
Yeah. It's,
you write in a verse, like, where do verses come from?
Right.
What was the point of those verses?
No, yeah, I relate to that heavy, you know? The idea of getting on that microphone and, like, it's that speech. It's just, that's why I love hip-hop. MCing, it's different.
What do you guys do besides rapping? Yeah, daily life.
Everyday life?
Everyday life.
Live, really, like, there's a point, because we talk about that all the time, like, you gotta really live, like, can't get caught up in, like,
give thanks.
Yeah, give thanks, really live.
That's the first thing, every time I wake up, thank you, Lord, for another day. You can't just wake up and just, oh, shit, I'm late, I'm mad. How you mad? Like, how you know you were supposed to wake up? Not everybody gets a chance to wake up.
True.
That's what I learned growing up with. So that's one thing that I do.
Like appreciate, yeah, like, appreciate. Live and appreciate, yeah, and then everything else, you know. Live, appreciate, give thanks, and then you go about your days.
We
stay fit, we
dabble in a lot of different or other like things inside of the culture.
Yeah.
Videography, photography, mm-hmm. Production.
Yeah.
Acting,
absolutely. Breaking.
Breakdancing.
Designing. So much, it's so much to like.
Well, I mean, people see New York as the mecca of hip hop. So, I mean, how do you guys?
Alright, so before we did the interview, and I read that question, you cut me off and you told me to keep it for the interview.
I should have.
I was waiting for this the whole time. I was wondering when you was gonna get to this. So like, New York, I would say this shit to y'all. Right? I'm like, yo, nigga, New York is the mecca of hip hop. Like,
yes, sir.
How many times y'all heard me say that shit? I say those words like word for word. Yo, the mecca of hip hop. Niggas, it has to be ill. We gotta come hard. Like, people look at New York like that's the birthplace. So it's like, oh shit, it's like it's an essence behind it. And I'm gonna tell you the truth. I'm gonna talk. Alright, my fault. I'm gonna go on a little rant real quick. So, I really feel like New York hip hop is different. Like, well, my version. Well, hip hop. Nah, hip hop. New York hip hop is different. I'm gonna tell you why. No disrespect to any other cultures, like their form of it. But, it's like, you saw the Roxanne joint, right?
Roxanne.
Yes. And you saw, just because it's relevant right now. Right? What I'm trying to say is this, right? Like, since it just came out, y'all saw how, like, it was, for her, it wasn't like, it was fame. It was some shit that she did in the hood. You know what I mean? On the way doing laundry, or, like, chilling in the hood. You don't got that much bread. You with your friends. Everyone going through the same shit you going through. But you happy because you outside. They playing double dutch over there. Shooting dice over there. Playing basketball over there. You got the rappers in the park. Like, that shit is real. New York is really like that. Like, it's really like that. We started off in the park similar, and we perform every year in the summertime at that same park. Like, just to show, bring that shit back, because it's real. It's really a culture. Like, it's a culture created by kids. Remember, hip hop wasn't created by grown men, it was kids. It was really baby, you know what I'm saying? And that was like 40 to 50 years ago.
Remember that scene of homies yelling out the window? He's like, yo, come record this verse. Yo, I got to do laundry.
Yeah,
that's real shit.
Like, it's, and hip hop, like, when I'm talking about hip hop, that's why when you ask me about the three rappers, I'm like, it's people that you don't even know. Because it's situations like that, you know? And how can I express that to niggas that's only, that they only version of hip hop is what they see on the internet? And my shit is the shit that I'm seeing. Hip hop isn't just rapping. I be with graph writers. These niggas is I feel like they're like one of the illest brains when it comes to the culture of hip hop, because their styles is more complex than certain rappers' lyrics. Just from how they do their pieces, and it's like, yo, how did you do that? And the colorway, like rap, certain rappers just pick a beat and rap over it, and they think because I got the hardest bars, it's the ill, I'm the illest. But it's not. The graph rider be like, yo, the background has to be ill. The 3D has to be ill. Everything, even the tag, even down to the fine detail. Certain MCs don't bring their shit down to the fine detail. So I respect graph riders. The B-boys, I be with B-boys all of the time. Shout out to all of the B-boys in New York City and around the world and in Japan. Be with the B-boys, these niggas is nasty. And it's crazy because it's like a hidden culture now. Like, niggas do it like in the cut. It's not as wide as it used to be out everywhere. They be in the cut doing it and they still get down. Like, it be niggas that get out of work getting busy.
Best
like,
believe, be like, breaking it is alive. Yeah, right. Absolutely.
And it's in their heart. You can tell, like,
they take that shit serious. Like, I say shit.
So it's really different. Like, when people talk about hip hop is dead, I'll be like, how is hip hop dead? And I'm still alive. Probably one of the smartest people you've ever met. Compared to the rest of the stuff that you're hearing, how is hip hop dead? Do you hear, listen to the music and you'll see the mind state of these people. You gotta understand, when you listening to Illmatic, you listening to Blueprint, and you listening to these classic albums.
It's about story.
Exactly, it's a story, so the story has to keep going for the albums to keep coming. It's not just a microwave, oh, boom, 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 every day it's a new album. No, niggas have to live to keep going. That's how I feel about the Mecca, New York City being Mecca. To sum up the question.
Oh, that was dope. Well, for the Japanese hip hop heads, I mean, do you guys have some slang that you could share with them that you guys use?
Mm-hmm. So there's dead ass. Like, if you dead ass, like, you serious.
Yeah, you dead
ass. Like, yo. Shoot the interview. Dead ass.
Dead ass.
What else is there? There's smacked. Now smacked can mean a couple of things.
Like, I'm smacked right now.
You could be smacked off the hand rhyme. You could be smacked off the spliffy. Smacked. Yo, I'm smacked right now. I can't make it to work.
Dumb smack. So dumb is another one. I'm dumb smacked. That food was dumb good.
Mad. That shit was mad fire.
Mad. Yeah.
Pull up.
Word.
You know, if I'm trying to tell you to come over, I say pull up. Or if I'm trying to get you to come to the studio, I say pull up to the studio. There you go, man. Like, word.
The couple, yeah.
There you go, right there.
Couple.
Yes, sir.
I mean, do you have any Japanese memories related to...
I mean, I remember.
Yeah.
I grew up on anime.
I remember this B-boy, what's his name? B-boy Tosuke, I don't want to get his name wrong, but, Japanese B-boy, I seen him breaking one time, and I was like, oh, like, Japanese breaking style is so extreme, like, athletic, like, I'm talking like, their power moves are ridiculous, like, so it was dope to see. I think he's better than like some dude from France or something. It's just dope to see the different styles, you know what I mean? So, it's just that mind state, like, what's he thinking, how, you know what I mean? Like, how's he doing that with his body? And anime, of course, you know?
I fuck with Japan because they're always like 60 years ahead of everything we do here. And since it's so far away, you just get to watch and see what they're doing. Like, I fuck with anime. Like, I used to be an anime head when I was younger. I grew out of it a little bit, but I still go back, you know what I'm saying? I like manga. My brother and my cousin both teach English in Japan, or have at one point. Yo,
I grew up on like anime and shit, like Dragon Ball Z, Naruto, Bleach, even other shit you probably haven't heard of, like Zetman, Toa no Kwan. Like, I've seen a lot of shit, and it's just like, it's something I've always fucked with. I've always fucked with just like shit that's so out of this world. Like, you know, being a young kid and looking at anime, and it's like, yo, that dude just threw a beam of like powers, like, what the fuck? You know, that shit just, it drew me in, and so I fell in love with, you know, anime and everything about it and shit, but like, I feel like more recent anime, there's less story and more just crazy fights.
Yeah, that's why I don't get into the new joints. I like the old school joints.
Because it had a story.
What do you guys have coming up next, What new projects do you have? Anything
you
want to share?
I just dropped the album Caught in the Air.
I just dropped a project called Blue Dream Cartoons. And I'm expecting to drop another project in the summer. So that's what I'm working on at the moment.
Working on an album. We just dropped the album not too long ago called Knowledge Born. Check it out everywhere. All platforms. Spotify. Just type in Knowledge Born.
Yeah, you should listen to that, definitely. Shout out to Minds Over Matter, everybody.
In Brooklyn.
Part of the project, one of my favorite projects. I got a cameo on the Roxanne movie on Netflix that I'm getting a lot of love on recently. More projects, more acting. Metropolis is dope. You got Chelsea on that.
Shout out to Chelsea Reject and Raz Fresco.
Raz Fresco
and Omen.
And Omen 4-4. Metropolis is dope. You got you got Chelsea on that.
Shout out to Chelsea Reject and Raz Fresco.
Raz Fresco and Omen. And Omen 4-4.